Joshua has a Tempest Trials reward, and personally I think he's definitely one of the best free rewards we have gotten so far. He has an insanely high base stat total, and all of his stats sit around a good average for each of them. His 40 HP is pretty decent, and definitely not too low. His 31 attack is helped out by his legendary 16 might weapon, and his 35 speed is actually pretty solid. 30 defense is definitely above average for a Myrmidon type unit, and his 28 resistance is boosted to a very good 33 when taking into account his legendary weapon's free plus 5 resistance. All in all, Joshua doesn't have any super standout attributes, but I wouldn't say any of his stats are below average. If you get the 5-star version of Joshua, then he immediately gets access to his Odd Huma, which simply grants a minus 1 cooldown to specials as well as plus 5 resistance. He comes with Moonbow, but I think that can be swapped out for something better. His A skill is Close Defense, and grants plus 6 defense and resistance when he gets attacked by any melee enemy. Wind Sweep at its 3rd tier allows Joshua to disable enemy counterattacks, but only if he outspeeds them by 1 or greater, and they are physical damage dealers, so that would be swords, lances, axes, bows, and dagger units. It also disables Joshua's own follow-up attacks if he is initiating. A very interesting kit to go along with his very versatile stat line. Now I'm going to go over some basic builds that you can use, and after I will discuss just what other kind of skill options you can run. Something that takes advantage of Joshua's base kit is a double close defense build, utilizing the new close defense seal that you can also earn from the Tempest Trials. When getting attacked, Joshua will effectively have the 42 defense and 45 resistance, which is just disgusting. With that much res, I think you should be running Iceberg or Glacies for insane damage spikes. I know people aren't fully sold on Wind Sweep, and I can see why, but this build wants to be an enemy phase tank that can also get free hits in when he can. Wind Sweep can let you get in free damage, charge your special, and also apply Speed Smoke, which is exactly what the Paralogue version of Joshua tries to do. If you apply Speed Smoke to the enemy's backline, then there is a good chance that Joshua can simply tank every threat that gets thrown at him on the enemy phase. An unorthodox build, but I think a tankier setup could see more value over a hyper offensive one for Joshua. Joshua is a great candidate for Distant Counter. With a Distant Defense Sacred Seal, Joshua sits at 39 res when attacked, and with his good speed, enemy mages are gonna have to work for those double attacks. Even enemy archers and dagger users will have a tough time getting through Joshua's effective 36 defense. And with Quick Riposte, Joshua can take out any mage, archer, or dagger user if he survives. I think a ploy type C skill is great, since ideally you can debuff the enemy ranged attackers before they get in range to attack Joshua. Now if you want something a little more familiar, I don't think Joshua is a bad user of the Fury plus Desperation combo. With a speed plus 3 Sacred Seal, he reaches a nice 41 speed and also becomes insanely hard to one round KO, since Fury is also boosting his defensive stats. For some people, the answer to using insanely high stat total units is to increase that even more using the Power of Fury. This would definitely be a build tailored toward arena matches and making sure you can end them before Joshua ends up killing himself. So I know a lot of people will want to build Joshua differently, so I've compiled a bunch of skills that for every slot that I think could be used effectively, although obviously you want to use skills that complement each other. Offensive A skills can include any attack or speed boosting skills to help out Joshua's slightly lower attack stat. Even Life and Death could be run, since it basically takes his pretty good defenses to a more normal level for sword infantry units. There are also some interesting defensive options you can choose from. Again, Close Defense and the Distant Defense skills take advantage of his already good defense and resistance stats. Even Steady Breath could be an option, although I don't think Joshua is the greatest candidate for that skill. The A skill usually determines a lot about your build, so choose carefully depending on what you want Joshua to do. These skill options are always interesting, and I would love to try out something like Wrath on him. Breaker skills are also already good, and Swordbreaker would help him out a lot when dealing with the more insanely offensive ones that outspeed him. Joshua's defensive options are also pretty good too, since high defense means he can use Renewal to heal back up, or even Guard to make sure no specials get past him. While 35 speed is good, for some builds such as the Distant Counter one, you may want Quick Riposte to ensure Joshua can KO those pesky ranged enemies. C skills in general always depend on the rest of your team. You literally can't go wrong with any buff, spur, or drive type skill if it helps out Joshua's allies. While a little more expensive, I think Joshua is a great user of the ploy type skills since 33 resistance is pretty up there, and he should be able to activate them against most heroes. The smoke line of skills are also really good, especially if Joshua can apply them for free by using Wind Sweep. Now Joshua is a pretty free to use whatever sacred seal he wants. I think it's still important to pick a synergistic one, since stuff like double close defense is insanely powerful. Quick and Pulse can be used with his cooldown reduction weapon for some interesting strategies, and Joshua could probably be a good user of Hardy Bearing, since I don't think he needs Desperation or Advantage if you don't want to use those skills. Phantom Speed works with his built-in Wind Sweep, although I personally can't say it's the best use with the Sacred Seal slot. If you're watching this from the future, then maybe this has already happened, but I think Joshua can be a good candidate for the upcoming healing specials with reduced cooldown. Adhuma and his amazing bulk seem like a good combination for a 1-turn cooldown Noontime or a 2-turn cooldown Soul. Now I can't say anything for sure, since maybe these skills will still be terrible. However, units like Joshua who are pretty tough to kill outside their obvious counters could become self-sustaining monsters. If I had a spare Nefni, I would love to try out the double close defense build with Wrath as the B skill. If Joshua can get into Wrath range, then now he gets that plus 10 extra damage as well as additional healing since Noontime and Soul do take into account the extra damage from Wrath. He'll even get more cooldown reduction on the next turn if he is still on low health. Joshua is absolutely a jack of all trades type unit, not insanely offensive or defensive, but holds a pretty good neutral game either way. As a free reward, you can decide on how you want to build up Joshua, and since he is already a 5-star hero, you get access to his legendary weapon as well as close defense 3. He can fill a variety of roles, and I think it will be a really fun unit to experiment with, especially as we get more and more skills added to the game. Even though we have many red distant counter sword users, Joshua does have the resistance and the speed to utilize the skill well. With that in mind, I don't think he is a bad candidate, especially if you feel like your other users are just not good enough to counter mages, if that's what you're looking for. Personally, just because it fits my playstyle, I am looking at utilizing more defensive builds for Joshua. From my little experience with him, the double close defense build is pretty awesome, but still I think it can be tweaked, especially by trying something other than Wind Sweep. I would like to try out Noontime and Soul on Joshua, and while it may not work out, I hope they do become viable skills eventually. I don't think there's a terribly wrong way to build Joshua, so let me know how you plan to build him. I definitely did not list every skill he can use, and if you find a build that works, then I would love to hear about it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will try to put out one more video before the madness of Update 2.0 hits in a couple days. See you then.